It is now time for the latest Zika update.
Planes are scheduled to begin spraying the controversial pesticide Naled over South Beach tomorrow morning. And that has activists worried the pesticide could do damage to humans and to the environment.
On Tuesday, that was when they were announced they were going to spray the Naled. There's a lot of outrage about that.
First at noon, Zika emergency protesters gather outside Miami Beach City Hall as commissioners discuss whether the city should fight the state's aerial spraying plans.
There's a town hall, a town forum, basically a commission meeting, but not an official meeting where any action could actually be done.
If I told you right now and the commission told you we don't want this, does that change your decision?
If the commission doesn't want this, then I need to go back to my attorney, county attorney, and say, do I have the duty and the right to do this?
Kudos to Commissioner Michael Grieco for taking a stand, organizing the whole town hall. Basically, the outcome of that was the county mayor said, all right, out of concern for the children, we're not going to spray Thursday, we're going to spray Friday morning, which makes no sense. Don't know if he knows that kids still go to school on Friday, and the reason he made zero sense, and I don't know, basically just delayed everything by a day. Friday came, they're supposed to spray at 5 a.m. I got up at 4 a.m. to go out and try to find the plane. It did not go well. I could not see the planes.
The worst would be if they actually did spray and I got doused with Naled and I didn't even get the shot of it.
I was hoping maybe they didn't spray, but they did spray. I just missed it. All right, Sunday morning. I'm gonna give this a second attempt. They're supposed to spray in about 20 minutes. This time, I have a better plan on how to capture it.
Sure is nice down here.
Got this camera going. Sure. Time lapse.
Turn on that.
I probably look like something out of Mad Max. I'm 99% sure that was the plane. Couldn't really see any gas coming out of it, but it pretty much made a U-turn right at 28th Street.
Follow the sun and look for me in Florida, for that's where I am sure to be. For that's where I am sure to be.
So I'm glad that this time I did not get sprayed with Naled and then not see anything. This time I got sprayed with Naled and at least saw something. And just in case anyone's wondering, no, I did not fly the drone anywhere near the plane. I kept it on land side, the plane was over the water side.
So I just wanted to add a note of why I'm doing this. Basically, I wanted to track down stuff that is happening sort of while we're asleep in the darkness in this battle against Zika. We've got trucks going around spraying, you've got airplanes going out and spraying. And if I could do something to sort of shine a light on stuff that is actually happening using the tools I have at my disposal, I'm all game for that. And I just kind of want to show what's happening. Something that you hear in the news that's a little abstract because this happens at night. You know, you probably hear about it, you go to bed, and then you're like, wake up and you're like, I wonder if they sprayed. I kind of want to show that. So that's the purpose of these videos, just to add some context to trying to capture these shots and capture what is happening out there. Now, I'm not saying that the government or the county should do nothing. We really need to combat Zika. Anything that affects infant birth, that is a huge problem. The debate is really how to best do that. But one thing that really hasn't been coming up is genetically modified mosquitoes.
This lab in the Florida Keys just received FDA approval to produce millions of genetically altered mosquitoes in the fight against Zika.
So when we release our males, they have one job, to find a female and pass on their genes. When they do that, they pass on the self-limiting gene to the female. the offspring inherit that gene. It's passed on to the offspring, and they die.
The FDA has approved experiments for this. I don't know, it just hasn't come up sort of in the conversation as like an option, and I don't know why. The Naled just seemed like a really large hammer for a nail that is still relatively small. That's it for now. Thank you for watching. They've done two Naled sprays. They've got another two scheduled. I probably have been dosed with enough Naled. I don't think I'm gonna film those. However, if someone does have a FLIR, a forward-looking infrared that can record, I would definitely go back out again and film it with that.
Follow the sun and look for me in Florida.
These are the Instagram ads you get when you live in the Zika zone. So I'm glad everyone can capitalize on geotargeting ads.
Here it's 85, and good to be alive, and I've been going swimming every day.